So coming to the selection process, you would have to prepare on three things. One is whatever you've written on your resume. So you would have to align whatever you would have to ensure that it aligns to the work that is required to be done once you join the desk. So you could demonstrate a fit in that domain by, you know, talking about how did you take ownership? How did you create certain alphas? And you should also be able to answer any academic questions. So in case you write certain names of courses, there would be a lot of technical questions coming up and refreshing and going back to those courses so that you're able to answer that question is really important. And another thing would be like preparing about the firm and the role. So research a lot about what the bank does, what the desk does, and what asset classes do they work on. And you get a chance to clear all of this during the buddy or a telephonic call. So the first round will usually be an assessment call with somebody from your same level, like somebody maybe a second year analyst or an associate. So this would be a good opportunity to clear on what the desk actually does, what are the asset classes, because in the later rounds, the technical rounds, you would again be asked what do you know about the desk. So you would actually need to be clear about how the desk works, how many people are there in the team, who are their clients, is it institutional or is it retail, or is it to an internal department within the bank itself. And another thing would be any news or public information about the department to which you're going to join and the classes, asset class and the desk that you would be working on. And the last would be the general markets knowledge. So this would be tested in your technical interviews. So usually they start with the big picture scenarios, like macro events, any specific macro events that have happened. Like in my summer interview, I was asked about the NBFC crisis and there was the ILFS thing happening. So you need to have a big picture view on why did that happen, who were the parties involved, and your own opinion. You need to form your own opinion about all these macro events. What I would suggest is usually you refer to newspapers, but also you should be able to talk about these events like at least for a minute and not just narrate what the event is, but also on how did it happen? What led to its happening? Were there any regulatory gaps that happened, or was there some liquidity problem that was there in the market that led to these events? So having a strong opinion and being able to defend it would be the key here. And the other thing would be market updates. So mostly the technical interview, it goes back and forth between either macro event or just market updates, like they ask you like dollar INR rate for today or the oil price for today. So these are small questions, at least the market update ones, but sometimes they are a make or break situation, because these are the basic you're really expected to keep up with. Like what is the current FD rate? What is the interest rate? What is the reverse repo rate? So all these you really need to update yourself with during the buddy call, during the technical rounds, and you have to update yourself with the latest ones. And finally, the term one and term two courses, which were macroeconomics and financial accounting. So the typical questions that come, like if depreciation I have depreciated an asset by a shortfall of $10, then how would it impact your financial statements? So those kind of questions that you find in most financial markets preparation modules, those would be tested. And The last one, especially for roles that are related to valuation, like equity research, sales, trading. So you would really need to know the basis of valuation, like you would need to know the payoff graphs, you would need to know DCF, you would also need to, like, there are certain technical rounds where you're given a piece of paper and given the details and you're asked to draw the payoff graph. So you need to know all those butterfly spreads, call, put, the basic payoff graphs for most of the instruments, I would say. So that it's more about recollection, except for macro events. Most preparation is about recollecting what is the ongoing market update and valuation, payoff graphs, all of that. So very few surprise elements would be there. So if you prepare hard, it's not not a very tough process to crack. Anything, any questions related?
Can you suggest any certifications that can be done in the capital markets space so that they could use it to highlight it on their CV or, you know, to gain some knowledge?
Mostly for markets, you don't need like a level CFA level 3, but CFA level 1, CFA level 2 are more than enough. Other than that, if you want like short, quick courses, then there are a lot of Bloomberg certifications that freshers do go for. And other than Bloomberg, you can also go for NISM or mostly valuation related certifications that, you know, short duration, 1 or 2 months, that have an exam at the end. Other than that, you could also highlight like any electives that you've taken, like I've seen, like, in case of Goldman Sachs, they did ask on the final placements, they did ask certain people that what were the electives you took up if you were interested in financial markets. So having a good grade for that would help.
To throw more light on what buddy calls are and what, how do they usually go, like, what are the questions that, you know, buddy might ask, and more information on that.
So actually, buddy calls happen because they want to know the preference, like, and how technically sound are you. So buddy calls are basically an evaluation round that happens over the telephone, and usually you're matched against alum of your own college, or you're matched against somebody from the same level that you're going to join. So I would say if it's a big, if it's a bulge bracket, you're matched against an analyst, or other banks match you against an associate. So buddies usually have to check whether you're keen on this role, how much do you know about this role. So it starts off with giving you a flavor of their life at the desk, or what they work on, whether you have any questions related to the role. And then there would be a short, around 15 to 20 minutes technical round, which would be extremely basic, like, are you following any sector? Like in case of sales and trading and equity research, you could prepare for a few sectors, like if you prepare for cement sector, then usually they ask you, like, put us 5 4s on it, or what are the revenue drivers for this sector. So extremely basic financial knowledge, and a few questions on do you know the asset classes, do you know what's the difference between a government security and a debt instrument, and what is the value, how would you value a public company. Those kind, not extremely technical, would be very short, and unless you do a very bad job, it's not consequential. So if you do extremely well, you're still going to be, everybody's still going to be interviewed. It's just the order of the interview that would happen would be based on how well do you do during these buddy calls.